Hallelujah.
Let's pray. Daya, please lead the prayer. Lord, thank you for this meeting. Thank you, Jesus, for the divine moment for our community and the service of God. We choose not to have it. Lord, we pray that you will not have it. Thank you, Daya. Before you class. Before you sit down, please arrange your chairs and pick up the pieces of trash that you can count on their chairs and tables. Okay, you may have. So, today, let's play first 4-piece 1 word. And I have here several pictures on the first orange cartolina that shows different pictures. The first set of pictures will give you the first word. And what do you think is the first word means?
The pictures from the left, I think the first word is metals.
That's it, if you're correct. And how would you describe a metal based on our previous discussion?
They are elements which are usually shiny in appearance.
Okay, other description? So, these three concrete metals are malleable, ductile, and shiny. Okay, thank you. So, what's the next word? So, you can see here, carbon, a lead from a graphite from the pencil, plastic bottles, and diamond. What do you think is that? Any guess? An R? So what do you think non-metals are?
Non-metals are not malleable.
Okay, so the other pair. Let's see if it's correct. So based on our lesson on the previous days, metals are malleable, ductile and shiny, and non-metals are all the way around. So to further discuss and further know what our lesson will be, I have here a fun page to take two words again, and this is the first word. How? So you're correct. What do you think conduct is based on our on your assignment? Any wild guess? Okay, if anyone don't have a guess, this is how we are going to use conduct. Please read. Mariel?
Allow.
So, what conduct will allow? And the next word is this. So, if there's an election and there will be a road, what word do you think will be?
Electron.
Yes. Flash. April.
Electron.
Yes. So, what do you think? What is electron?
So, wala yung chrome na ginawa ko.
Correct answer. So, if we combine the two, meaning tanda, electron, or some movement, today we are going to discuss about any guess using these words and the previous so those in so far. Any other?
Okay,
so today we are going to discuss the connectivity of metals and non-metals. So what property is this? So now we are going to perform two activities, one activity in two groups. Okay, so the first activity, please read, Nikki.
Relight the app procedure. Prepare the materials. Test the samples like connecting these elements to the end of the circuit. We observe what will happen to the light bulb.
Okay, thank you. And the next activity, Erica. Okay, thank you. So, while answering, I will perform those tests. I want you to be able to answer these questions. And first is, read fully.
Which of the samples were able to light the bulb up? Number two, which of the samples were not able to light the bulb?
Three. Any other hands? After that, please read the orange color green.
Which of the samples were able to let the samples fit? Which of the samples were not able to let the samples?
Okay, so these questions are very easy and these are the follow-up questions that we are going to answer. Number one, Greg, please read
number one. Which are metals and non-metals from the given materials? Number two, between metals and non-metals, what materials have higher number? And number three, what is metals?
Okay, so where are the group one? Dave and the Lunar. Group two have group two and group three your side and group four. Okay, so for group one, so you will perform the light bulb off. The materials that you need are there. So I will only give you about 4 minutes to perform those tasks. It's very easy, okay? So if you need a lighter, I gave it to the to group four. So if you have any questions, just approach me or raise your hand.
Touch ba dapat? What's going on?
Thank you.
Ni kaya natin yung sarili.
Ganda naman. Tuwan-tuwa si yung kanyang mga kamay.
Okay, if your dad is not surrender your the materials to the facilitators. Okay, did you enjoy the activities?
Yes.
No one gets hurt, right?
Yes.
Okay, so the first question is, which are the metals and non-metals from the given materials? Group one, what are the metals in your materials? Based on the appearance, okay?
The wire.
The wire? And which is the non-metal?
The straw.
The straw. Group two, what material did I give you? Same materials. Group three?
The non-metal in our activity is the charcoal and the steel.
Could you, Francis, could you please show the charcoal and the steel, okay? And the group four, what are the metals?
Our metals are the copper. The metal in our experiment is the copper wire, and the non-metal is the wood.
Okay, so let's see if we have the same answer. Okay, so these three who haven't read it yet.
The metal is copper and the non-metals are charcoal, right?
Okay, so next question for those who are assigned to light me up. Now, which of the samples were able to light the bulb? Group one.
The
copper wire. Group three.
The copper wire.
And?
The charcoal.
Charcoal. Let's see if we have the same answer. Okay, so my answer here is copper and charcoal. So next question, please read. CJ. Number two.
Which of the samples were not able to light the bulb?
Okay, which of the samples, group one,
The bamboo stick.
The bamboo stick, let's see. Okay, so we have here the stick and the straw. And next question. This read. This read, Jeannie. Next question.
Which of the samples were able to lift the palm dog's pen?
What was your answer?
The copper wire.
The copper wire? And the group 2?
Same answer.
Same answer. So, next question, please read. Anyone who haven't read yet, raise it.
Which of the samples were not able to lift the palm dog's pen?
What's that?
The stick.
The stick and group 2? Same answer. Okay, so I have a follow-up question. I want you to look. Later, have you noticed that charcoal is, what do you think a charcoal is again? Is it a metal or not metal? It's kind of not metal. So, I have here a representation diagram and it's not really exact. So, since you are still grade 7 and you haven't talked about anything about valence electrons, I just want you to give a brief overview that atoms have valence electrons or electrons on the outer shell of the atom. So, in metals, have anyone read that metals have only 1 to 3 electrons? Yes, valence. And the non-metals have usually 4 to 8 electrons. So, if copper or any metal is moved by any external factor like energy, it's moving. What do you think will happen to the electrons? If it's, for example, it's moving in a circular manner. If you can imagine, what will happen? Does it move freely?
So, yes ma'am.
Yes. How about if a non-metal like carbon? What do you think will it happen? Does it move freely? Of course it moves freely. But what do you think is the difference between the two? Any?
It will. The space.
The space. So if the space of the valence electrons affect the movement of the electrons. So what do you think? What do you call the movement of that electrons when moved by an external factor? Based on our, you can use the atomic pairs that we have used, April. So if it's conductivity, so what do you think conductivity means? Using the concept of these electrons. So conductivity is something that. Any other hands aside from me, Will? Anyone? Yes, Pao.
Conductivity is a property that allows the electrons to move or to move.
Let's see if you're correct. Thank you. This wreath is rosary.
When the activity is a physical power, it allows electrons to move.
Okay, you got it there. So first concept is this. And what if metals have less valence electrons outside it, and carbon has has the number, greater number of electrons outside it, and based on our experiment, what do you think, which material have higher conductivity? Sarah?
Metals have higher conductivity.
Okay, so, the leaf are correct. So please read, Rena.
Metals have higher conductivity than metals.
And metals.
So that's our lesson for today. So for our, if we have, see if you have something, if you learn something, and I want you to think of this value situation that I have given you. Please read, please.
Server wave is a lesson for speaker. Suddenly, he saw an unconscious man. Right? As he accidentally touched a live wire that is not coated. Being knowledgeable that a metal wire is a very good conductor, which they burn him. What value does the first speaker manifest before taking an action? A. Look for the main switch and turn it off before giving the first aid. B. Give him a first aid right away. C. Get out of the area. D.
So what could we do?
I will look for the main switch and turn it off before giving the first aid.
So what do you think is the value that that manifests if we chose that?
Because I know that if I touch him, I will be burned too. So I will switch off the switch it off before touching him.
So, any other answers? No, yes, there's no wrong answer here. Minar.
A person right away, because as far as I know, when a man touches a live wire, it suddenly, parang mapapalayo po siya dun sa patawag ko, bigla mapapatagal po siya ng hapon. Tapos,
so, these four choices are all correct. It's just based on how you are going to handle it, okay? So, I think you are all ready for our quiz for today. Facilitate first. So this is very easy. And I want, you only have, I think, 3 minutes for this. It was done. these exchange papers, and we'll check, and we are going to check the answers. So these are the answers, C, and all of them are A's. So question number one,
why is C?
Oh sorry, it's letter A. So any who got wrong answers number one? Okay, then you answer is letter A. Number two. Number three. Number four. Number five. So I think MJ, you got wrong. Number five. So what's your answer number five?
Letter B.
Okay. So as we all know, some people know covers not only the metal wire that can be used. Actually we can use other more lighter elements. But copper is really good conductor aside from being
cheap.
Abundant energy. So before we proceed to our assignment, any questions? None. Verifications. Okay, so our assignment for next meeting, we will now proceed to biology, I think. Mariel, please read.
Assignment number one, create a poster about the importance of building conductivity, how metals and nonmetals do well. The file must be printed and be passed next meeting. Number two, word search, microscope lens. Number three, bring the following coloring materials and lighter.
So, before I discuss, anyone don't know what lobster is? It's online, right? But I wanted to print it in a PDF file or just print it in one paper. So, that's all for today. Thank you.